Hi guys, welcome back to JoJo Lab. Recently, we got the brand new Redmi K60 Pro. This time, it supports 120 watts wired fast charging and 30 watts wireless fast charging. And today, we're gonna do multiple tests to check its charging performance. The original charger inside the box is a 120 watts GaN charger from Xiaomi. Compared with the previous 120 watts, the size is smaller, but unfortunately, it still adopts a USB-A port. And there is a special contact inside to support PD protocol. Let's see the specs info. Modlist MDY-14-ED. It can support input of 120 volts, 50 or 60 hertz, 3 amp. The 11 volts, 6 amp and 20 volts, 6 amp will be the Xiaomi's proprietary protocols. So the original cable is a customized USB-A to USB-C cable. The internal contacts have been widened to increase the current to 6 amp. Connected to JoJo Lab Power ZKM003C, it can support QC 3.0, PD 3.0, and Xiaomi 96 watts protocols. It also has 4 fixed PDLs of 5V, 3A, 9V, 3A, 15V, 3A, 20V, 3.25A, and 2 sets of PBS. The size of the charger is about 59x56x28.5mm, and the weight is about 155 grams. So the power density is about 1.26 watts cubic centimeter. It integrates two self-developed charging chips Surge P1 inside. The 20 volts 6 amp will be divided into two circuits inside the phone, and each circuit is 20 volts 3 amp. Then the charging chip will buck the voltage to 5 volts and increase the current to the 12 amp. Finally, it'll be merged into 5 volts 24 amp. The built-in charging solution will convert the voltage and current to charge the battery. We also used the Xiaomi 80 watts wireless charger to charge it. It can successfully trigger the 30 watts, and the KM002C shows the power is around 30 watts. After briefly introducing the charging process, let's test its charging performance. The original and previous 120 watts chargers can be above 90 watts, and we also tested the Xiaomi 67 watts, 35 watts, and 33 watts. All of them can be compatible with Redmi K60 Pro, and the USB-A charging cable can also be used among those original chargers. However, the charging power of most third-party chargers will be limited to 20 watts. The PBS chargers can trigger 8V, 2.5A, 20 watts. The chargers without PBS protocol can only trigger 9V, 1.4A, 12 watts. No charger can trigger 15 volts or above. Then we'll use the original 120 watts to fully charge the Redmi K60 Pro. In the beginning, the voltage increased from 15 volts to 18 volts. Then the voltage is stable at around 18 volts. In the first 4 minutes, the power is stable at 100 watts. After that, the power gradually drops to 56 watts. Then the power will fluctuate with the current between 56 to 63 watts. And after 15 minutes, the power gradually decreases to almost zero. It takes 20 minutes to be fully charged. We also draw it into another curve to see how fast it is. It can be charged to 20% in only 2 minutes, 50% in 7 minutes, 80% in 14 minutes, and 100% in 20 minutes. Except for charging speed, the charging temperature is also what customers focus on. After 5 minutes of charging, the maximum temperature on the front is 42.4 degrees Celsius, and 41.9 degrees Celsius on the back. After 15 minutes of charging, the maximum temperature on the front is 42.1 degrees Celsius and 42.9 degrees Celsius on the back. So the overall temperature is pretty stable at around 42 degrees Celsius. Well, that's all tests for the Redmi K60 Pro. With the 120 watts charger, it can be fully charged within 20 minutes. Even so fast, the charging temperature is well controlled, at around 42 degrees Celsius. But its compatibility is not very good. Both wired charging and wireless charging need to be worked with the original accessories to achieve the optimal charging speed. If you want to see the charging review of other devices, you can leave your comments down below. Please drop a like and subscribe to us. See you in the next video. Bye!